found a way to stream two screens from your MacBook instead of just one. And that is so amazing. I'm so happy about it because that was the main reason why I wanted to get Vision Pro in the first place, to be more productive, and now it is real. You can do it. First, let me stream this screen from my MacBook here. So I'm just going to tap connect to have the big screen right in front of me instead of this little screen. Yeah, this is much better. So as you can see, I'm streaming just one screen from my MacBook right now. For many people, it's not the ideal way to work. Multiple screens is a way to go, especially if you have the ability to do virtual screens. Now, this is not the official way of doing things, but there is a third-party app that was just developed and it's still in development, and it's called Split Screen. And I got early access to Split Screen. It is not available to general public now, but you can apply to get this early access too. I will leave a link in the description. So as soon as you are done watching this video, go there, sign up, and hopefully soon you will get access to it as well. But before that, let me show you how it works and what you need to do to actually make it work. So once you have this split screen, you open this app on your Apple Vision Pro, you'll get this little window that'll ask you to connect to your Mac. In addition to having this app on your Apple Vision Pro, you also need to have a split screen client on your computer, which is basically the same as if you use Immersed on Quest 3, you also need to have a client on your computer. So I already have split screen installed right here. Here it is, split screen. So once you've installed that and you opened it, you'll get this little icon in the top right corner. Let me make the screen bigger. This little icon in the top right corner means that a split screen client is running, and once you've connected Apple Vision Pro, meaning once you've opened the client on your headset as well, you will see it here, Apple Vision Pro. It is not grayed out, it's active, and I click on it and that's it. This is the second screen. To prove to you that all of this is working, I have my mouse connected, and here's my mouse. Extends to this screen. So the limitation of this screen compared to the native one is that it is 1080p. It's not 4K. The quality is different, and you know, there's not as much stuff you can fit in here, but it is a natively extended screen. It is not just an Apple Vision Pro app. You can go ahead and switch your screen positioning. So for example, if you go to your settings and to display, so here are these two screens. You can simply rearrange them if you want to position your virtual screen to the right side. Then I obviously need to move it to the right side as well. Here you go. Now I click done. Hold on. And this virtual screen is now on the right, and the mouse is moving to the right side too, and I can move my windows straight inside. Basically, it is a virtual monitor, the virtual monitor on your MacBook. It works perfectly, and it's exactly what I needed for video editing. You can have your windows, so you can just use it exactly the same way as you would, you know, working with two screens. So if I have my video editing software here, and then let's say, you know, I want it open really big because that's how I usually work, and then I also want to find something to download, like here, I will move my Chrome, Google Chrome here. I'll type in Envato because I want to download something from here. You can make it quite like as big or as small as you want. It's really cool. Like, you position it anywhere you want to so that it doesn't cover your main screen. So here I am. I can have like my window with some videos here, and then I move them from here. I move them here. Now I have my video that I downloaded. So this already makes me so much more productive than I was before with just having one screen in front of me. And there's one more thing that I want to show you, because this is the app that is still in development. And I found that they have a list of things that they want to add to this app, like here on the roadmap. There's a whole bunch of different aspects that they want to add: more resolutions, sending audio from Mac to Vision Pro, portrait orientation, open Mac apps as separate windows in Vision OS. That will be so cool if you open Mac apps and they pop up as separate apps, just like they do as native apps on Apple Vision Pro. Send your Mac display to your Apple Watch. Send your Mac display to your iPhone. Create more than one extra display. So currently you can work with two monitors with the help of split screen, but in the future they will have more. They're working on having even higher resolutions, and those are all the things that you have right now. So again, I'm going to add the link for you to apply to get the early access to this app as well. Right now, this is just something that keeps popping up, implant temporarily not working, and it doesn't go away. But yeah, the mouse is working. It's super responsive, there's no lag. Two screens is already so much better for me. It's still not a perfect app right now. There are some bugs, like if you try to check like different things here, at some point I've noticed that the mouse got stuck and it wouldn't go back to this window. It would only stay in the main window. So it's not perfect, but this is still in development and I already can use it. It is completely usable and so cool. I still think that the native support might be coming to Apple Vision Pro at some point, because there are rumors saying that internally people who work on Apple Vision Pro already can stream more than one, but maybe they are not sure about pushing that to the general public because of latency and bandwidth limitations. But still, this third-party app, Split Screen, is working and you can use it. I don't know when it's going to be open to public, but for now it works really, really great, and I definitely will be using it so much now that I have two screens on my MacBook. It is a complete game changer. I've also recently made a video comparing the productivity tools that you can find on Apple Vision Pro with the ones you can find on Meta Quest 3, so definitely give it a watch. I'm sure there's a lot of interesting stuff that you can learn from that video. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.